You don't know about me without you have read some books made by Mr. Mark Twain. Well, Mr. Mark Twain sure did write down an awful lot of them adventures. He never wrote them all.
Now, this huckster we're hunting up, Mr. James Holt. He's a parasite and ain't a place for that kind in this world.
I see you coming, you crook!
You're the adventurer. I just tagged along time to time. You catch an adventure like please.
And you don't.
Gotcha, you, Bilgewater!
I say, do my poor old tired royal eyes deceive me, my dear Duke? Or is this our old mate, Huckleberry Finn? No, no!
I think you boys have both grown accustomed to payments from the trust I started from that treasure you both found all those years ago.
Your chickens come home to roost, Huck. You gonna help us?
With what?
Getting rich.
You should have talked to me first, Tom. You bet Sid that this bag of feathers will land the same time as his 10-pound stone when we drop them both off garbage rice.
That's what we spit on, but it's a gimme. There's no threat. Ain't you learned by now I don't take a bet that ain't a gimme?
Tom, are you the reason for this foolishness?
Huck helped.
Tom Sawyer, you are the most narcissistic, humiliating, self-obsessed corner that I have ever seen in my life.
You think Becky will ever speak to me again if we done court for good?
I don't think you have to worry about Becky Thatcher now, Tom Sawyer.
Sorry. Thought I saw it. Becky!
That wire drops at 32.2 foot per second squared.
Them big words just to say you ain't outrunning it.
See, that big cage back there had the potential for energy because gravity was pulling on it trying to bring it down, but couldn't, account of the counterweight.
See, there's this naturally occurring thing called magnetism. Whoa. Something you can't see, but you know it's there.
I ain't never seen no Tom Sawyer without a plan, sir.
Tom!
Seems like every adventure Tom Sawyer's ever been on, right there by his side, has been Huckleberry Finn.
Ain't nobody coming for you!